Today I'm reviewing three Bluetooth dongles from XTOOL, the newly released AD20, the AD20 Pro, as well as the A30M, which has been out for a while. I'll show the comparative differences between these scanners and how the diagnostic capacity and functions of these dongles increases as you go from one device to the next. You might find one of these quite suited to your scantool needs. Now let's get to it. For full disclosure, I received these scanners as free review samples from XTOOL, but XTOOL has no hand in the content of this video. There's not much to unbox. Both the AD20 and the AD20 Pro look exactly the same, and each pack contains just the dongle and a quick start guide. These dongles have a really small form factor compared to other Bluetooth dongles that I've used. The unboxing experience is similar for the A30M, just the device itself, and then this activation card. There's no manual, you have to scan this QR code to get the manual. Build is really good and it actually features a flashlight which you can turn on through these buttons on either side. Let's get into the review. Starting with the AD20, this is an entry level scanner or code reader. It will read generic OBD2 codes as well as manufacturer codes only for the engine system. Both the AD20 and the AD20 Pro make use of the Advancer 20 app, which you can either get from Google Play or the App Store depending on whether you use Android or iOS devices.
I have the car on because there are a number of tests that we're going to run for which the car is required to be on. You would see that once you power it up, you're given this interface and there's a quick test option that is available. Once you tap on the quick test option, it begins to run through a number of live data, battery voltage, coolant temperature, engine load, the revs, basically some vital data points, and then gives you a list of four tests that you can run, which we're going to come back to in another menu. So where you would really want to head to, everything you're seeing here is going to be contained in this application center. So if we go into application center and you click on trouble scanning, this is just basically a generic OBD scan. XTOOL has been a bit gimmicky here in terms of making it look like an all system scan. The AD20 is not an all system scanner. This is more of just checking for generic codes by each of these systems. Come out of there. The next thing is an in-depth check. In-depth check is a manufacturer level scan, right? So it has to go online to get some data. I'm in a Honda and this is using Honda's protocol to scan the engine system. So no codes there. And then you have live data. On the live data, it gives you a quick snapshot of these PIDs. And of course, you can go in to check more sensor data. If you click on that, it's going to give you a laundry list of all these live data points and you can select to view all and then say next. One thing I would say here is that this car uses the CAN OBD protocol. So this is generic live data under the CAN OBD protocol. It's not the manufacturer level live data. You're going to see when I change to a different device, you're going to see what level of data we're going to get. And so we back out of there. And then there's also the smog check, which helps you to know if you're going to pass emissions testing. One other thing I wanted to touch on is the mode 6. Under mode 6, you have a number of data points which you can use for diagnosis. So one very popular one is the misfire counts. Misfire counts by cylinder, cylinder 1 misfire count, and so on. Nice feature to have. And then one other thing they've added is the component tests. If I enter the carbon build-up test and say start testing, this essentially is not a manufacturer level test. This is XTOOL making an interpretation of some live data points, like level of opening of the butterfly valve versus the RPM and some other things to make a determination of whether your throttle body is clogged up. And then you also have the fuel one. If I do that, it's also going to give you a sense of whether your car is running rich or lean. So as you can see here, it has both the long-term and the short-term fuel trims, and that looks good, so no problems there. MAF sensor, the same thing. For this, it's just basically going to read the level of flow of air through the MAF and cross-check that with engine load. 2.49 grams per second at idle, that's fine for this engine. One other important one to talk about is the battery check, which I think is a really nice test that they've added here. Please turn off the engine. Please turn on the engine. And then it begins to analyze. And then it tells me the battery is good. And then the DIY corner where you can set this dashboard up. If you want to do all those 0 to 100 and so on and so forth, you can use that to do that. So essentially, that's the AD20.
So taking off the AD20, I'm moving over to the AD20 Pro.
The only other thing that the AD20 Pro adds is this vehicle maintenance light reset, and the fact that if you do an in-depth check, it's going to go through all the ECUs in the car, so against just doing the engine ECU. I'll have the exact time it took to run this on the screen. So, and that's the all system scan, so the engine and so on and so forth. So basically all these grayed out ones are systems that are not available on the car. Back out of there. Switching over to the A30M. The A30M makes use of the Anyscan app, and straight away you can see that this layout is exactly the same with XTOOL tablet style scanners. And what this adds on top of the AD20 Pro are two main things. First, you have the special functions. You have 21 special functions that could work on your car. I say could because it depends on what's equipped on your car. Doesn't mean all these things will work in your vehicle. But for this 2017 Honda Accord, I'm pretty pleased that you can even do things like gear matching. For example, if I go on this Honda, it goes on to communicate. I can do the teaching process, and then it begins to tell you you need to put the vehicle on a hoist or a lift and so on and so forth, and then all the procedures to do that process takes about 10 minutes. Really nice special function to see on this Bluetooth dongle. I don't want to do that. I'll just back out of there. And then of course ABS bleeding, TPMS reset, injector coding, and so on and so forth. So that's the special functions. The other thing is under diagnosis. So let's just do an auto scan here, and it reads the VIN quite quick. I say okay, it's the 16-pin USA. This can do an all system scan, so I'm not going into that. We've already shown that with the other tool. Let's do a system selection. This is a bidirectional tool, so if I go into engine actuation tests, you have essentially the same number of actuation tests that you have on the D7. Direct fuel pressure test and all those things. And maybe we should do some of them. I don't know if you can hear the radiator fan. It's raining, so I don't want to go outside. But let's turn that on. And then I'll click on. I don't know if you can hear that, but the radiator fan is now on. I'll turn it off. Maybe if I go into the body system, that's where we can do some things that we'll be able to appreciate on the car. If I go into wiper actuation test, let's command wiper. Sorry for the banding. Let's command low command. So you can see that's working. I can go into door locks, actuation test. Unlock our doors. You can see that works. And here's why I said that the AD20 or the AD20 Pro doesn't give you access to manufacturer level live data. You can see here that these are 157 PIDs versus what you have on the AD20 Pro or the AD20. So this is essentially all the live data that Honda puts out. Cylinder cranking speed, all those things, you're going to have it.
In terms of cons for the AD20 and the AD20 Pro, internet access is required to run the in-depth scans or the manufacturer level scans, and this is because the tool has to link up with XTOOL servers while performing these tests. While internet access is now a given these days, I just thought to flag this so that you are aware of it. One other con I thought to mention is that since both of these tools have access to manufacturer level scanning for the engine ECU, I would have expected to have manufacturer level live data. Another con of these two devices is that they only pair with one car at any time, meaning that if I want to switch from my Honda car to a Toyota, for example, the pairing with this car is going to be lost, and when you come back to this car, you're going to have to go through the pairing process again. None of these are deal breakers, but things you should be aware of. That said, I genuinely like the component tests that these two devices support, especially for people who are new to OBD2 diagnostics, who may not yet fully understand how to interpret live data and use that to make a diagnosis or finding faults in a car. I also think that the battery tester is a very nice addition to add to these dongles. For the A30M, this is really a solid professional tool. I tried hard to really fault this, but couldn't pick up on anything. For you to have all system scanning, service functions, bidirectional tests, in addition to no subscription fees, that's really hard to beat. Also, the speed on the A30M is the best I've seen in a Bluetooth dongle. It's even faster than some full body scan tools. As at the time of making this video, here are the pricing for these tools on Amazon. However, be sure to check out the links in the description for the current pricing, as well as exclusive discount coupons to this channel, which you can use to get a better deal. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace!